Hello everybody, thank you so much for tuning in to Riders United YouTube channel. And today I'm in the beautiful San Diego, and I thought it would be really nice to ride the bike in California, which I never did before. So I decided to rent the Harley Davidson Road Glide, and I will just see what's going on. And if you'd like to see if renting the bike is a good or bad idea, please stick around and I will show you what I got. Here we go. Okay guys, so I'm gonna go and pick up the motorcycle. Just so you know, when you are renting the motorcycle from the rideshare, they will take your personal information. You will have the options to choose the insurance that they offer just in case something happened to the bike. And this current rental was a little bit over $100 based on the information provided before any additional charges that I'm expecting as far as insurance. So I will definitely update you on the total cost for the trip. And I will have to take a few pictures on the bike, and the person that will be renting the bike will also have the opportunity to document the shape of the bike before they give it to you. And they will provide the bike with the 100% fuel. So there are a little bit of like formalities, but I don't expect that will take really long. I have to say the person that will be renting me the bike was really responsive. So I think that this is a good thing. So let me just get up there right now and yeah, let's see what we got. Okay, so we are here. Let's check this bike out. Okay, so I just rented the bike. I mean, I finished the inspection really quickly that was required by the rideshare. I have to say, it's not really, the shape of the bike is not really what I was expecting, but it's kind of like late to back off from the deal. So I think I'm gonna take the bike with me and hopefully I will safely get to Santa Monica and come back. And yeah, let's see how that goes. Yeah, this bike was just filthy when I got it. I mean, it was a shame to really get the bike like that, just to rent it to somebody. I mean, you guys cannot really see that in here, but yeah, this bike is dirty. Alright, so we get to our final destination, which was Santa Monica, and I have to say, yes, we got here, but man, what a trip that was with this bike. This bike is definitely neglected as far as maintenance. I noticed that the tire on the back is almost gone, and like levers from the clutch was like rattling. There is some other issues that I will do like few videos about. So yeah, so far it was like really mixed bag of feelings about this bike. So the fuel gauge was actually showing like different amount of fuel in the tank depending if you were like speeding up or slowing down. So if I was like speeding up, it was actually like going lower, and if I was slowing down, it will go higher. I couldn't really use the lock because the lock was also not working, so I have to carry all the helmets with me. But yeah, that was funny part in here. As you can see, the bike was on the ground. There is like multiple scratches in here as well. Yeah, and that was probably not like small fall. There is like scratches on the saddlebag. Okay, I'm ready to come back slowly back to San Diego. I have to say, yeah, it was not really nice bike to rent, and I kind of started regretting this, but hopefully I will get home safely
Yeah, I have about 100 and something miles to go back. And yeah, let's at least enjoy this ride as much as I can, because the views are definitely beautiful in here. So yeah, let's hop back in.
Okay, so we just came back from our little trip from Santa Monica, and it was about 250 miles. I returned the bike to the owner about 30 minutes ago, and I have to say it was quite a disappointing experience. I mean, I tried to save some money comparing the rates from the rideshare to the rates from the dealership. I probably saved about $100. At the end, the total for the rental was about $160. So advertised price was $104 for the whole day of riding on this bike. But of course, there were like some additional fees for insurance that I decided to take on this bike, because I mean, I'm in a different state, different things can happen. So I thought I will be extra cautious. I chose the option for the insurance that have $2,000. Deductible. So after the ride was completed, I have to take additional pictures of the bike, and owner have to do the same. So he have to kind of confirm that he inspect the bike after I return it. And yes, I mean, beside the things that I mentioned about the bike that I noticed, I think that the bike was a little bit misrepresented on the ad on the rideshare. And actually it was not a little misrepresentation, it was like big one. I think that this bike wasn't maintained for probably really long period of time. I have to say, at some point I wasn't really sure if I'm gonna make it safely home, but I mean, I was really careful. I didn't go over 80 miles an hour on the highway, and I think that that was the kind of the speed that I felt a little bit more comfortable, especially not on my motorcycle, and the fact that this bike was a little bit heavier. And if I will have to do it again, will I do it? I think that I will do it, but I'm not necessarily renting the motorcycle from the rideshare. I felt that if I will have to do it again, I will probably go with the rental from the Harley Davidson dealership or any other motorcycle dealer that is providing those kind of services. I really was looking for trying this touring platform, and I have really high hopes. And I think that yes, those are really nice bikes that are really capable of touring, because I mean, I have to say the bike was like really smooth overall, but I think that at the same time there were some major issues with the bike. I mean, it was even unpleasant to get on the motorcycle that was so dirty. And I have to say, the person that was renting me the bike was really accommodating. He really tried to make sure that we can meet at specific time. He even offered to deliver the bike to the location that I was where I was staying. But at the same time, I didn't think it was worth it. I mean, I was also renting this bike to check if maybe the touring platform will be something for me to consider in the future. But I have to say, just based on what I experienced with this specific motorcycle, I think that this will be better misrepresentation of the touring platform, because I feel that these bikes are really capable of riding for the long period of time and providing the comfort for the rider. But the motorcycle that I rented was really in bad shape. I felt that the engine mount was probably old, because I felt a little bit more vibration that I was expecting. So this is everything I got for you guys today, and please like and share. I always appreciate any comments that you guys might have. Maybe your experience was different. I definitely would like to hear from you guys. What was your experience in case you were renting the motorcycle in the past? And also, if you have any comments and would like to connect with me on the different platforms, I have also account on the Facebook, and of course I'm on YouTube where you are watching me right now. I have the Instagram account, and sometimes I also post on the TikTok. So feel free to connect with me on the different levels. I always would like to invite you to my Facebook group when we can talk in the real time and we can exchange the information. And I always look for your comments. So thank you so much, and see you next time. Ride safe, guys, and take care. Bye-bye.